This is Vancouver's downtown east side. It occupies an area about 8 blocks long by 3 blocks wide. Thousands of people call this home. I was born here. Through years of neglect, it's become Canada's poorest postal code and an open-air drug market. Hustling, stealing, dealing, hooking. Addicts do whatever it takes to survive in what they call the life.
And this old race will soon be over. I'm coming up. I'm coming up. Although my burdens, sometimes they press me down.
Hey, Arnie, let's go. Great start.
Yeah.
Tony and me, we both grew up down here. This has been my beat for the last 20 years. And I've seen its good days and its bad. Over the years, we've seen hundreds of kids disappear into the dope scene down here. Some of them eventually find a way out. Most of them don't. And if you want to stay lost, this is the place to do it. You gotta want to be found. People ask us, what'd you do wrong to get assigned down here? And I say, you don't understand, most of my friends are down here. They either work down here or they live down here. You know, it used to be the heart of the city. And I can remember how it was, and I refuse to give up on it.
Hey, Crystal.
This is my neighborhood.
So what are you partying on tonight, huh? What did you get a hold of, crack, meth, what?
Oh, like, something happened, something's down.
Why don't we take you home?
Your place.
No, not my place. Maybe Arnie's place.
No, not my place. The maid hasn't been in here this year.
Dance with me. Come dance with me. Tony, you dance with me.
I can't. Crystal, look, I got the wrong shoes on.
You know what? And you got none. So why don't we just dance ourselves down the road a piece before you cut your feet all up, okay?
Hey, I know you. Didn't I tell you if I saw you down here again, I was going to kick your ass?
I've been kicked in the ass. Lots. It's crack. You want to
know? All right, all right.
right, you know.
You know what? Why don't we call the paramedics, have them take it down to the hospital, get some clean sheets, a shower, get yourself straightened out, huh?
I don't feel very well.
Okay, why don't we just get you over to the hospital then? Okay. You all right?
Come on. I only left for 5 minutes, please.
You went out. You know you can't come back in unless you got $10. You know the rules.
I don't have $10.
Hey, Danny.
Hey, guys.
What do you got for us?
Any problems tonight?
No, sir.
Come on, please.
Come back when you get the money. Eh?
So how you doing, Danny? You still sticking with the program?
Oh, yeah. I go to meetings every day, sometimes twice.
Jimmy, put some pants on.
It's been almost 5 years.
Now, how about Mark? What's his story?
Mark, he passed away.
Who's in 216?
Sean, but he's in the hospital.
Rose? Rose? You open the door, please? It's Arnie and Tony, Vancouver PD. Dan, you got a key on you?
Yeah. Shoot, it's locked from inside.
Oh, shit.
Oh, God. She just uses heroin, right?
Yeah, as far as I know.
Rose! Hey, Rosie! You with me? She's breathing.
All right, I'll call the paramedics.
Rose, come on! Rosie! Hey, Rose, wake up! Wake up, Rose! Yeah, come on, you feel that, huh? Come on, help me out. Whoa. Come on. Sit up. Oh.
Yeah, thanks.
Come on. Here, let's have a talk.
Leave me alone, Tony.
When's the last time you checked these rooms?
I've been busy watching the front door.
What? Dan, you know the law. You gotta check them every 24 hours.
Well, I try. What are you gonna do? They want their privacy.
Well, I don't want to come in here and find another 3-day-old dead body. Okay, you remember the last time?
What am I gonna do? I'm all alone. I gotta watch the front door, do the maintenance, check the room.
Maybe it's time to get out of this neighborhood, huh? Find yourself some new friends.
Rose, where's your husband tonight? Is he out scoring for you?
He's selling cigarettes. He takes care of me.
Yeah, he's a real provider. What's the kid's name?
Amber. They got a bunch of posters they're putting out.
Yeah, we've seen her around.
Yeah.
You got a name for a pimp?
Yeah, Victor Pinto. He's got a warrant out on him, death threats against an officer.
Oh, yeah, we know who he is. Vic Pinto. We'll keep an eye out.
Any reason why she might have left home?
No, these are good people. I've known John there for 30 years. She's just a wild kid, that's all. So keep me up to speed on this, okay?
Yep.
John?
Yeah?
I'm going to inform the downtown squad to be on the lookout for Amber, all right?
Okay.
In the meantime, these two constables will take care of you.
Sure.
They know everything that's going on down here. Okay? Don't worry, we'll find her.
Much appreciated. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Arnie. This is my partner, Tony. Hello. So when was the last time you saw Amber?
About 2 weeks ago.
Yeah.
She came home for the night, and in the morning she was gone.
What's she been using it for, how long?
Over a year now. Heroin, some cocaine.
Yeah,
most the heroin now.
Was she having any troubles at home? Any issues that might have encouraged her to come down here?
No, what kind of issues do you mean?
No physical abuse in her past, at school, anything like that?
No.
When she was home, did she say anything about her boyfriend?
Not much, but she looked bad, like she'd been knocked around a bit, I thought.
I know we're not the only parents looking for their daughter down here, but if you hear anything at all.
We'll look for her, we'll let the vice squad know to keep an eye out, but you should go back home.
A block for the 7 miles of barbed wire. I use a cobra snake for a necktie. I got a brand new house by the roadside. Made a rattlesnake hide. I got a brand new chimney up on top made out of a human skull. Come on, take a walk with me, honey. Tell me who you love. Who do you love?
Anybody here?
All right. Let's start. Oh, yeah. Raymond Charles Ressler. 16 months for theft from auto. Now he's out. All right, we know this guy. He's an habitual TFA. He's probably looking for money to score.
Yeah, I tagged him already last night.
Oh, yeah? What's the story there?
Well, I was in the Datsun and he broke into my cruiser and stole my gym bag.
Yeah. Anyway, I chased him into Oppenheimer Park and he's already trying to flog my karate gear on the run.
Did you get him?
Yeah, I got him.
Okay, well, here's some more good news. The pickpockets are back. We're looking for two men and a woman. The descriptions are in your sheets there.
What's this? I don't know these guys.
Oh, they steal coats off the backs of chairs in restaurants. Had a pretty good run last year on Denman and Robson, right?
Yeah.
Well, they're downtown now. They ran this game in some jazz club on Water Street yesterday. Got away with half a dozen wallets and charged up $20,000 worth of stuff overnight. Ooh. Yeah. Okay, we're still looking for Amber Riley. Anybody hear anything, you let her appointment know, okay?
Buddies up here against the wall, right here.
Hey, what happened to catch and release? Toss her back, she's too small.
What are you guys doing here? Where the hell's the wagon?
It's probably emptying out after your last roundup.
Gotta go!
Got a runner.
Hey, you're not gonna catch her! It's not like catch her, she used to be city check.
Yeah, that'd be before she started shooting junk, I guess.
You guys okay? You guys need a hand?
No, we're good.
Okay.
Hey, come on, he's up against the wall. Stay right there.
Yeah, her name's Amber. She moved out about a week ago.
What about her boyfriend? Is he still keeping room here?
No, he went with her. Last I heard, he was hanging out in the clubs recruiting.
Okay, well, just keep that copy around, stick it up somewhere.
Are you kidding me? Yeah.
You know,
hey.
Call.
Oh, shit. Oh.
Didn't we just drop you at the hospital?
No, they wouldn't give me anything. No downer, nothing. They just wanted to pump my stomach, so I left.
Okay.
No. Come on.
You know, we're going to have to charge you this time. You know that, right?
Well, I wasn't doing anything.
Oh. We've been going through this routine with you for 5 years, Crystal. 5 years.
Whoa.
You got any needles on you?
You know, the last time we did this, you swore to us you were going to go to rehab.
I don't think so.
Uh-huh.
Nope.
Yes, you did. I had that stack of Bibles with me, remember?
Huh?
Look, if you want to go all the way down to the church and get a stack of Bibles, you want to go through that?
Yeah.
Forget it. Here. Swear in my notebook. It'll do. Raise your right hand. Your other right hand. Here, look, repeat after me. I'm gonna go to rehab.
Gonna rehab.
Okay, beautiful. We'll get your things.
I have no things. When are we gonna go?
We're going right now. We're gonna take it down to the medical center.
No, I got some stuff I gotta
do. No, we're going now. We're going right now.
They won't take me from high.
Yeah, they will. The doctor there's gonna get you to recovery.
You gonna visit me?
Yeah.
You gonna visit me like a real friend because you care?
Yeah.
We'll visit. Come on, get in the car. Watch your head. We'll run by your room. We'll pick up whatever you got, your toothbrush like that. Then we'll run by the doctor, okay? Get your feet in.
Feet in.
Hey, Ed, it's Daryl and Matt.
How you doing tonight, Ed? Hey, been doing speedballs?
Yeah, it looks like he's been doing speedballs. Okay.
Can you get up?
Yeah.
Atta boy. There, good. No, easy. Take it easy. Be mellow now. Okay?
No. Easy. Look, Ed, I just want to shake your hand. How much you spend a day on dope, huh? Think about it. You gotta be making at least, what, $50,000 a year?
It's a lot of smashing and grabbing for one man, $1 at a time. That's really hard work.
That's right. That's really hard work.
Yeah, it's really hard work, Ed. So come on, let me shake your hand. There you go, okay. So now I gotta cuff you, Ed, all right? You turn around now.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay. All right. You got him?
got any needles in your pockets tonight, Ed?
No.
You sure? You're not lying to me, are you?
No.
I don't want to get poked.
No.
You gotta start taking better care of yourself. I got some company here.
Hey, Sergeant.
So who we got here?
This is Ed.
Yeah, what are you gonna do with him?
I guess we'll run him down to the psych ward, have them look him over.
Yeah, call the wagon, let him sleep it off in holding.
He'll just be back down here tomorrow.
Yeah, and if you take him to the psych ward, he's gonna be an hour out of your shift, and he's gonna be back here the day after tomorrow. I think a better use of your time will be finding the dealer to sell them his dope, don't you?
Want one of your smokes? Here you go. It's an awfully short smoke, Ed.
As long as there's been a drug trade, I've followed the conventional wisdom of the drug war. Arrest the dealers. Chase the addicts. Pretend it's getting better. It's not. It's a 24-hour-a-day drug scene down here. And the list of casualties is getting longer and younger. And we're lying to ourselves about it.
Now this feels like deja vu.
Isn't that what hell's supposed to be? Endless repeat?
You know, it's like watching the exact same movie, night after night, on permanent replay. I'm gonna get a camera. You know, start taping all of this. Just show what it really looks like down here.
Come on, nobody wants to see this. Nobody wants to take it on.
It's like all the music videos, hey? Right? They make all the violence and the dope and the pimping and everything look so sexy.
You wanna make a horror film?
Yeah, I mean, scare the hell out of them, right?
That'll be entertaining.
I'm gonna get a camera.
Evening, lady.
Hi.
So I think I've seen you in here before, right?
Uh-huh. I know you too.
Yeah, I'm a regular in here.
You came to my high school 5 years ago to give us a talk on drugs.
Oh yeah, what high school is that?
Boyd Edward.
Yep. Yeah, that would have been me. So, did what we talk about have any effect on you, or did it just go in one ear and out the other?
Your partner's waving at you.
Hey, what are you running for, Victor?
I missed my morning workout.
Yeah, you seemed a bit slow off the mark. Guess you know we have a warrant here for your arrest. You were threatening an officer?
Allegedly threatening an officer.
Oh, that's a nice watch. It's gonna come in handy in prison. Tell the time in years. Where'd you steal that?
Hey, my girlfriend gave me that watch.
Your girlfriend, Amber?
No, that's not her name.
You don't know a girl named Amber?
No, I can't say that I do. What does she look like? Maybe I can help you out.
Well, you'd recognize her, Vic. You had her locked in your room, turning tricks for you.
Come on, does that sound like something I would do?
So we take you back to your room. We're not going to find her tied to the bed.
Nope. But the thing is, Victor, parents are down here looking for her. They want their daughter home. They don't want her down here shooting heroin and screwing strangers.
Hey, look, I want to help you guys out. So what do you say we go back to my room and you can take a look? Satisfy yourselves.
Why don't we do that?
Hey.
Yeah, we're looking for Crystal. Oh my God, I didn't recognize you.
I didn't recognize myself. I was seeing things for a while there and I didn't know where I was.
Pretty rough, I guess.
Yeah, it was pretty awful.
You been doing any thinking about what you want to do when you get out of here?
Yeah. Yeah, I have. I've been thinking now. I'd like to get a little house somewhere. You know, maybe out of town or on the island or maybe have some animals. I'm good with animals, so maybe be a veterinarian's assistant.
Sounds great.
Yeah. Joe wants to do it too, so.
Joe? Are you still with him?
Mm-hmm. He's come to see me a few times.
Isn't Joe part of the problem?
Well, he's clean now.
He's clean? He went to rehab?
No, he kicked by himself. Some people don't need rehab.
Really? They just click their heels together, turn around three times, and they're cured, huh?
Where's he living now that he's clean?
Downtown.
So he's kicked and he's still living in the skids. How's he gonna recover? He keeps coming back to the scene. You can't recover down there. Crystal, if you even see Joe, this whole time, all this effort will have been a complete waste. You know you can hit the streets, you'll be back on the dope in an hour.
I'm not going to the streets. My aunt said I could stay with her on the island until something comes up.
Well, is she picking you up? How are you getting there?
Going straight to the bus station.
Well, what time's the bus leave? We can give you a lift.
Why don't you trust me a little? I can make it.
Well, you're going to keep in touch with us, right? Let us know.
You got a penny, Artie?
Nobody's born wanting to be a junkie. I mean, that's nobody's life's goal. Like, I want to be addicted, eh? I mean, in my experience, most people, they want to live a simple, respectful life. And addiction is just something that happens along the way. It's like the bottom that has no bottom. This is a picture of Joanne.
Damn.
On her first or second day on this on the street.
Woof.
And this is a photo of Joanne 6 months. 6 months later, about 2 weeks before she died. You guys. Yeah. You three right there, right in the middle. Here you are, being goofs. Right? The three goofeteers, huh? Perfect. I'll be showing your pictures next year in this class. Be one of you guys on a morgue slab. And you can't help thinking when you look back on how things turned out that maybe you could have done something different. Some little thing that might have changed the story. But I've seen enough that in a way that's always in the back of my mind. And I end up thinking I am doing all I can think of. But there's always something to miss.
Don't suppose you've seen or heard anything about Amber?
No, if we had, we would have called you.
I was hoping maybe I could leave this with you in case you run into her or she doesn't want to come home. Just some underwear, or soap, toothpaste, bath oils, things she likes.
So how are you holding up?
I've learned to take it one day at a time. Thanks for taking this.
Sure, yeah, you bet.
Okay.
I said get out!
Hey, Crystal.
Hey, Arnie. Tony, how you doing?
We thought you were over at your aunt's in Nanaimo.
Yeah, that didn't work out. Doing good, though. I'm just going to a meeting.
Well, get in. We'll give you a lift.
Yeah.
No, it's just around the corner. Oh, shit. Look, I'm sorry. I'm really sorry. You guys took me there and everything. And I was doing good, you know. Pretty good. 12 days clean. It's just too hard. I can't get off the street. I just can't.
Listen, we've been going to the high schools and talking to some of the kids, right? And we thought it might be a good idea if we had somebody with us who'd been on the streets, you know, who'd been there.
An expert. You're an expert, right?
Yeah. Expert. Been there, done that.
Be like, you know, an hour, one afternoon.
I don't know.
Crystal, look at us. We're cops. I mean, we go into the high schools, they see the uniform, they can't relate. They all know we're going to say that drugs are bad, it just doesn't penetrate. But if you went in there, they'd see you.
Not very pretty, is it? Oh, hey, here's Joe. Hey, I'll be just a minute, babe.
What do you say, Crystal?
Okay, I'll do it. Just tell me where and when, and I'll be there.
Well, no, we can pick you up. We'll take you there.
You know what? Just give me a wake-up call. And I'll call a taxi.
That's it, everybody. Thanks for your attention. Arnie, Tony.
Yeah.
Victor Pinto, Amber Riley's pimp.
Yeah, he's out on bail, I think.
Yeah, he sure is. One of the guys on early shift got a call from a prostitute saying he threatened her with a gun.
Is she willing to charge him?
Oh, no, she won't cooperate. You ever check out where he was living, see if Amber came back there?
Yeah, yeah. I mean, we made the rounds. Keeps a few rooms that he deals out of. Changes them around all the time.
Well, have another look. Bear in mind he's got a gun now. I mean, he's got to show up sooner or later. He's going to want Amber with him when he does. Get him off the street again.
Yeah. Hey, Amber Riley. Her book, she's been here.
I don't know her name. Turning tricks, still reading fairy tales.
Yeah. You're gonna call us as soon as you see her, right?
Yeah, I'll call you. Hey, Lillian! Knock it off! Knock it off. Hey, empty your pockets of all the rocks. Come on. All of them.
Hey, across the street. It's Amber, right? Who do you love? Who do you love? Say, who do you love? Who do you love? Who do you love?
I think sometimes it's like those dreams where no one can hear you call out when we're looking for some young kid and they've just melted into the scene somehow. You know, I think they must be calling out too, thinking how come nobody hears me. All of us,
calling out, nobody here. It's funny. But you keep calling. And maybe the hardest thing is when somebody does hear you, but they're already out of reach.
All right, that's it.
Hang on.
Back to school.
This should be good.
Yeah, I used to worry about getting HIV. And I used to think, you know, what are you going to do? You know, you try to be careful. But then I got hepatitis, all three kinds. And then when I tested positive for HIV, I just stopped worrying about it. So.
How did you get addicted?
My boyfriend gave me my first shot. He didn't force me or anything. We were at a party and everybody else was doing it, so I just went along.
Where'd you meet him?
I went with some girlfriends to a club down near Gastown there. And I knew he did drugs, but I didn't know he was going to turn me out on the street when all this dope was gone. And if it happens to you, you're going to have to go out and suck some guy's dick to show him how much you love him. My advice to you is to stay home. Stay off dope. Take a look at me. Take a good long look, because I could die from the bad choices I made, and I'd sell my soul again just to trade places with any one of you. Any takers, huh?
Effective.
You okay?
Yeah. Did you guys give me a ride somewhere close to downtown?
Hey, come on out of there. Excuse me, Boyo, step on out of there.
What do you got in your hand? Come on, show me. Open up.
Just a pipe.
Just a pipe. Okay. Getting high?
Trying.
Trying hard. It's a job sometimes, am I right?
Yeah.
What's your name?
Jason.
You got a last name, Jason?
Parsons.
2 Charlie 71?
Go ahead.
Yeah, could you run a party boat?
Tell me if you're carrying any rigs in your pockets, right, Jason? We don't want anybody getting HIV down here tonight, right? You know all that's going around down here, huh? Got every kind of hepatitis. A, B, C, we got the whole alphabet right here.
Yeah, don't use needles, all right?
Yeah? The pipe keeps you pretty busy, huh?
Yeah. Okay, thanks.
So you just come down here to score, or you live down here?
Just came to score.
Any warrants on you? Any convictions?
He's got a charge for possession.
They dropped that charge.
Yeah? Why'd they drop it?
Huh?
Because I agreed not to come down here.
And here you are. Crack was calling, is that what happened?
Yeah.
It's just like those mermaids, Arnie.
That's exactly like those mermaids. You know the story about the mermaids, Jason?
I don't know any mermaid stories, no.
You don't know the story about the sailors? They hear the mermaids singing. They sail closer, closer. Suddenly they're on the rock. Ship's going down. They're all drowned. Oh, what's this?
Okay. Let's stand still. Just like that, I'm going to take your picture.
What do you want my picture for?
Well, so we can identify you when we find your body down here. Tell your parents. Don't smile. As police, we have an unspoken contract with society that we'll take care of the problems down here. You don't have to look at it. And the other part of that contract is not to get personally involved. Some guys need to play it that way. But I've tried that, and it just doesn't work for me. This is still my neighborhood, and I feel responsible for the people in it. And I guess it would be habit, too. After 20 years, how am I going to change? It's what I do.
Jeez. Ed? He's dead, man. Ed's dead.
Get the Narcan. Hang on to him. Once this stuff kicks in, he's gonna start kicking and screaming.
Yeah, if we're lucky.
Back up, back up. Okay, settle down now, Ed. You're going to be okay.
Guys!
Maybe a shot of Narcan. Okay. You're gonna feel like shit for a while.
Ed. Ed, you okay? How you feeling, Ed?
I was doing fine. Until you guys came along and messed me up.
Okay, people. Let's not forget about Amber Riley. What's the latest on that, Tony? Where have you been looking?
Oh, we've been looking all over. We almost had her last night, but she got picked up by some John, got away.
I'm looking forward to some good news there.
Yeah, we also wanted to mention, Sergeant, that we're doing the slideshows in the schools.
Right.
And we took one of the addicts in there to speak with him, and she made a really pretty good impression. Right. And some of the street people down here, they got a lot of different stories that kids should hear. So it might be better if we got a video camera and started taping the addicts, right? Let the kids see that. And let them hear their voices that way.
You want the department to foot the bill for this?
Well, yeah, it'd be part of the ongoing project with the kids.
I think we'd be up for getting involved with something like that.
Yeah. Look, I'm sorry, gentlemen. I mean, it's commendable, but our IDENT section can't even get decent cameras right now. Besides, that's not really legitimate police work anyway, is it? Finding Amber Riley is. So, if there's nothing else, then just check your sheets of what you didn't get done last night. That's it.
Good idea.
Guess that kind of puts the kibosh on that.
No, I didn't hear a direct no in there.
Oh, I did. I heard a big, loud no and a kiss my ass.
No. What I heard is we can't afford it, but if you want to provide your own camera, then, you know, go ahead. That's what I heard.
Sorry, Chris, I got it. Good. Okay, that's red. Okay. Good. Yeah, you can start now.
I go? Okay. I was born in Nanaimo. And when I first came down here, I didn't even know what this was. When I first shot up, I fainted before the needle even found the vein. Now I can't even find a vein. This is where I shoot up now, right in there. But sometimes that doesn't even work. And there was a time when I was too embarrassed to even say the word blowjob. But now, that's how I make my living, up and down Hastings Street. And I can't take it back, what I've gotten into. I mean, it's my life. But I wouldn't put a dog down here. I wouldn't. But then nobody made me do it either. You know, nobody tied me down and shot me full of dope. I mean, I did this to myself.
I'm not gonna rat anybody out, man.
No. You wouldn't be ratting anybody out.
No, you'd just be talking about yourself. Where you came from, how you got down here, how you started shooting dope, stuff like that.
Yeah, well, I don't rat anybody out, man, especially not myself, you know?
It's not a confession or admission of guilt or anything.
You know, I'm not too proud of what I'm doing, as if I want my family to see.
What, they don't already know?
No, they don't, you know, and I'm not gonna put them through that or me through that. I mean, just look at me, man. You know?
Like, how would you like it if I just came down to your house and stuck a camera right in your face?
You've been down here, what, 5 years doing heroin? And all we know it, you know it. I think your family knows, too.
So what? No, I'm not gonna sit there and humiliate myself on that camera. I mean, hey, I'm Nick. I'm dying of AIDS. Kids, don't shoot dope.
Right there. That's maybe something you want to get off your chest.
I'm not going on tape.
Okay.
Thanks, anyway.
I didn't know he was dying.
How much are you gonna pay?
Lillian, we don't pay. We're making tapes for kids so they can see it.
I gotta make some money. Mm-hmm. You guys pay me $20, mm-hmm. I'll do anything on tape for you.
So that'd be a no, then.
Oh. Yeah.
You know, guys.
Hey.
Hey.
How'd it go?
Nobody wants to talk.
Nah, everybody's afraid we're gonna use it against them in court or their mother's gonna see it.
Maybe they got a point. They got a right to some privacy.
We could ask them to do it anonymously, maybe.
Yeah, they're already anonymous. Nobody sees them, nobody hears them. I mean, the whole point is to get them telling their stories.
Yeah. Hey, you know how they have those shows where they block out the eyes or fuzz the face? We could do something like that, right?
No, the truth is in the eyes. We got to get them to look right in the camera and use their own voice. That's the point.
I did this to myself. I have nobody to blame but me. And when I first came down here, I didn't even know what this was. This is where it shoot up now. Up right in there. And when I first came...
So what do you think of this, Carol? Any of this grab you?
Yeah, I guess, in a disturbing, tragic kind of way.
There's a butt in there.
But it's hard to watch. It's too heavy.
Yeah, well, it's supposed to be hard to watch. It's... You know, it has to disturb people.
You see what happens? You disturb people too much, they walk away. Won't watch it.
No, I'm not saying I wouldn't watch it. I'm just saying it's heavy.
Yeah, okay, but what's the point of just winding people up with nowhere to go?
I don't understand your problem. What's your problem?
I feel like it's pretty raw to put Crystal through that.
Look, she wanted to do this. Remember, she...
Yeah. I'm just not sure I see the point of it.
What are you saying? You want to stop taping or what?
No. I'm just asking, what's the point? What's the next step? I don't know if it's enough just to show people how brutal it is.
I was a spelling champion in my grade 7 class. I won the spelling bee. Hepatitis. H-E-P-A-T-I-T-I-S. Now I got what I used to spell.
She's usually with a guy named Vic Pinto. You seen her?
Don't recognize her.
Yeah, didn't the other clerk tell you we were looking for her and to tell us as soon as she came back here?
I don't know. Maybe you left a note somewhere.
Okay, listen. You keep this picture of her in the desk. Here's my card. And when you see her, no matter what time it is, you page me.
Sure.
Yeah, he is, Rose.
He's gonna get up soon.
No, he's not.
Yeah, he is.
Rose. Rosie, the coroner is here, and he doesn't show up unless somebody's dead. Mm. Hey, Arnie. Mm. Yeah. Mm. Rose, what's your husband's name?
Ask him yourself.
I'm gonna take his pulse for her. Here is maybe like what they say about being combat ready, and that before anything's even happened, you're incredibly alert, fueled by the anticipation of the unknown. And that works on all kinds of levels. The
surprise doesn't have to be physical or violent. It can just as easily be a conversation that connects a forgotten thread from another case. Or something that's funny when you least expect it. Or something that's heartbreaking.
Yeah.
It's kind of what keeps you keyed up.
So what's the story here?
Landlord says she threatened him, then she came out here and started the fire. We started talking, she asked if I was a friend of yours. I said, yeah, so.
Thanks, we'll take over.
She's all yours. Landlord's getting a garden hose to put out the fire.
Okay.
Thanks.
Thanks for calling us.
Hey, Rose. What are you doing up this end of town?
I used to live here in that building with my husband.
Nice.
There's entities in there now. I can feel them all around me. Watch yourself. I gotta get rid of them. I gotta purify myself.
Rose, you're gonna have to do this somewhere else, okay? Landlord said you threatened him with something?
Oh, he got some in my mouth.
Whoa, Rose, what are you doing?
Clearing the entities.
Okay. You know what? I think we're gonna call the mental health car and we're gonna get him taken down to the hospital.
We'll get you in for an assessment, okay?
Well, I already know what they're gonna tell you. They're gonna tell you I'm not.
Well, it'll give you a place to stay for a couple of days. You can get yourself cleaned up. You can get some clean clothes, some clean underwear.
The entity's in my chest. I can't wait. I gotta get rid of them.
Okay. Here we go.
My book!
I got your book.
They got doctors at psych that specialize in entity problems, okay? Come on, you can sit in the car. We'll make the call. Watch your head.
Okay. Here's your book.
Got a little too real for you?
No, it just didn't seem appropriate, that's all.
Thought you wanted to capture the heavy stuff. Camera doesn't lie, something like that?
Well, there's a lot of leaves out, too.
That's what I said.
Driving to work this morning.
Right.
So I'm stopped at the intersection where the train, sometimes the train crosses there and there's a train. Slow, long. And I can see between the gap, you can see between the gaps. So I look up and I see her. There she is, my daughter. And she's got her thumb out, but it's obvious she's not hitching. She's working. So I get out the car, try and get to her, but the train. I'm shouting out her name. She can't hear me. Because of the train. And by the time the train's gone, she's gone. Some idiots picked her up, and
I think Pinto rented a couple of rooms last night, so I was checking them out, and I saw a girl was in one of them.
You think it's Amber?
I don't know, maybe, yeah.
You didn't see her come in?
No, I just got on shift.
What about Vic? Where's he at?
Well, he went out when I came in. This is his other room here. I think she's in there.
Amber? Amber, city police, open up. If it's her, I'm gonna hog tie her.
Yeah, that's if you can catch her.
Amber, hey, open up. Dan, there's a guy in there.
Open this up with you. Angle.
Hey. Hey.
What?
Step out here, pal.
What? Where's Amber?
I don't know.
So who are you?
I'm Jack.
Jack? Jack? Jack who? Jack a lantern? Jack be nimble?
You got some ID, Jack?
How come you didn't answer the door and we knocked, Jack?
So I was sleeping.
Yeah, it must be contagious. Everybody's asleep in here.
You ever been in trouble with the law?
No.
2 Charlie 71.
Copy.
Yeah, could you run a party surname Morgan, usual spelling, given 1 Jack, given 2 Vincent.
Copy that, checking.
You're in a little bit of trouble there, Jack.
I didn't do anything.
Oh, you don't know? You were snoring. Yeah, we had a nuisance complaint. Snoring too loud. It's against the noise pollution bylaws. We have to respond if it's over 10 decibels, you know.
I was snoring.
Yeah, you're snoring like a bear in January. It could be apnea. You know? That'll kill you. You're snoring away, you can't get any air. You have a heart attack, you die.
Thanks. Jack, you lied to me. He's got an arrest for trafficking.
Got any drugs or weapons in your room right now?
No.
Do you know Amber?
No.
She's Vic's girlfriend.
Vic's got a lot of girlfriends.
Give Vic a message for us. You tell him we're looking for Amber, and when we find her, she better be healthy and happy and wearing a big smile on her face. Or we're gonna take it personally, okay?
All right.
Sorry to bother you.
Get some sleep.
Oh, hey. I've been looking all over for you guys.
Ed, what's that in your hand?
It's a sandwich.
Sandwich. What are you gonna do with it?
I'm gonna eat it.
Yeah? Incredible.
You guys saved my ass. I'm looking for you to tell you that. Do you remember?
Oh, yeah, we remember. You remember that, do you?
I remember waking up the next day. I remember feeling awful. I remember feeling like I was paralyzed. I remember you guys and everybody being on top of me.
Yeah, we were hoping you were gonna wake up.
I could see that. You know, I was floating above my body. I was getting ready to die.
Ed, you did die.
I don't remember that.
What we need now, Ed, is the resurrection part.
What do you mean?
We mean we don't want to see you die down here.
I don't want to die down here.
Well, that's good. Okay. And what do you think about a methadone program? So we get you started on something like that.
You know, I just don't feel ready for that. I really don't.
When are you going to be ready, Ed? You got to do it now. No, you're not a cat. You don't have 9 lives to be wasting.
I know that. I know.
You guys were asking me why I was doing this video. And I was thinking about it, and I think it's because nobody looks at me anymore. They look past me, or they do a detour around me on the street. But now they have to look at me and hear my voice and know me a little. I once had a baby and I couldn't take care of him proper, and he died. I loved him so much. I just need a minute.
That's good. That's good.
Yeah. Okay. I gotta go pee.
Okay.
Don't go away.
Okay.
It's easier not to know the messy details of our lives. It's easier not to burden each other with our troubles. But it's revealing those troubles that tie us together. Makes us a family.
Look, just give me my money! Just give me my goddamn money, you fucking asshole! Just give me my money!
Hey.
Hey, Amber.
want to go to the hospital or you want to go home?
I don't want to go anywhere. I just want to die.
Calm down. Just calm down. You have some blood on your... Tony, you got one of the wipe on it.
Well, you found me. Congratulations.
Gave us quite the chase the other night. Making us look bad.
I know. What am I gonna do?
Well, you can go to the hospital. Or you can go home. What do you say?
It's up to them now. They've got to work it out.
Well, you think her parents are equipped to deal with it? She could use some professional support.
I don't know. They're two very bright people. They've got all the resources they want. I mean, we've done all we can. We're not babysitters. And we're not documentary filmmakers either. Anyway, you found Amber, so you can take satisfaction in that.
Well, both my parents had a lot of money, and I took piano lessons and ballet. I went to convent school, and I had manicures, pedicures, 5-hour hair appointments, designer clothes bought in Paris on holiday. But now when I look at myself in the mirror, I don't recognize myself. I mean, sometimes when I smile, I see who I was a little, but I don't like to smile a lot because my teeth being so rotten and awful, and you know, the dope, it does that. It ruins your teeth and your skin. I know something you guys don't know.
There's a lot we don't know.
No, you don't know this for sure.
Okay, I'll bite.
Well, you guys, you know, you think showing the video to the kids is going to help them, and, you know, and I hope it will. Talking to that camera, for me, you know, was like talking to myself. It's like my real self. And I was like, I was hearing my life in it, and it was interesting, my life. It's interesting.
Your life is interesting.
Yeah, but what I'm saying is that you think your life story is these disconnected places that you're stuck in, and I'm saying that those places aren't your life. It's the road connecting those places. That's your life, that road. And I see myself on that road.
That's the one that's paved with good intentions, right?
But never in your limited imaginations did you think that me doing this video was going to help me like this. Jeez, that looks like my old convent school.
You okay? Feeling okay?
Scared.
Oh, come on. East Hastings Street is way scarier than this. Rosie, you can do this.
I don't want to be alone, you know?
You won't be alone.
Well, maybe you guys could stay and we'll have a cigarette or...
Hey. Hey. You're gonna make it. Come on.
Narcan going in.
What the hell are you doing to me?
Okay, Ed. That was a really good take. You don't need to die anymore. No more ODing, okay, buddy?
Crystal, let's think about this. Listen to me, Crystal.
No.
Crystal, hey. Hey, it's not a tall enough building to die. You know that, right?
Yes, it is.
No, do the math. It's a 60-foot building and you weigh what? What do you weigh? What do you weigh?
No. 110.
No, you don't weigh 110. You weigh like 80. It may say 90 pounds minus 60 feet. That's 30.
Huh? No! Artie, put this in your movie! Artie, put this one in your movie!
Crystal, hey, look at me.
Artie, put this in your movie!
Crystal,
Artie.
Look at me. Crystal, hey, look at me. Look at me. Hey, look at me. Look at me, Crystal. Look.
No!
How old are you?
I'm 20! 20!
You're 20. You're 20. 30 minus 20 gives you what? Gives you 10. Right, minus how tall you are. How tall are you?
No.
How tall are you?
I'm 5.
Yeah, you're like 5 feet. 10 minus 5 is 5. Yeah, 5 foot something.
Watch the curb.
Okay, two big steps.
Right. Hey, yeah.
Come and see me, okay?
Yeah, I'll be there later.
Yeah, and you bring me some cigarettes, okay?
Okay. Just get your legs inside, you get warm. Okay, get warm.
Okay.
Then he pushes my wife down. So I attempted to grab him, stop him. And that's when he hit me in the face.
So this was...
Vic. That guy. My daughter's pimp.
Was he alone?
No. I felt like someone was there in the car. I don't know, I didn't see anyone.
What do you think he was after?
Money. That's what he said. One of them expects us to pay for her drug debts now.
How long has she been gone?
A few days ago, she...
Yeah. She went up to visit some friend. Where was it?
Hope.
That's what she said.
Where's Vic?
He's not here.
You got any rigs in your pockets?
No.
Come on, where is he? Where's Vic?
I don't know.
You know, if you're lying to me, you're gonna be picking your liver out of your
teeth. I'm not lying to you, man.
Hey, Tony, 8 ball. Right here.
Amber's been here. It's her jacket. Okay, let's start again.
Where's Amber?
I don't know. She went home. She's at home.
No, she's not at home.
Where were you tonight?
I've been here all night.
Got anybody who can back that up?
I want to talk to a lawyer.
Yeah, let's call a wagon.
You know, Vic came back here about 3 hours ago.
Was Amber with him?
Yeah, she went out with some guy waiting here in the car.
Have you seen him before?
No.
How about the car?
Well, a fairly new BMW. Alberta license plate, I think.
So did Vic and this guy go off together or what?
And they had some words, and then Vic walked off towards Gastown.
Oh, so Amber went off with this other guy in the car?
Yeah.
Okay. Thanks.
So what do you think? Call the parents, put them through this?
Well, I don't know. They could be anywhere.
I think he sold her. She's probably halfway to Calgary or Edmonton by now. Fax that out to Calgary and Edmonton and tell them to expect to see her on the street out there any day now, okay?
Okay, anywhere else?
Yeah, Seattle, Portland, Victoria.
Okay, I'll get right on that.
Thanks.
How do I look?
Beautiful.
No, I'm not. So you're gonna pick me up Thursday at 3, right?
Yeah.
We'll be here.
Now, where do you want to do this, inside or?
Can we do that outside?
Yeah, sure, wherever you want.
I was 15, the first time I shot dope. Well, I had this friend in boarding school, and well, she was kind of like my sister. So somebody offered it to us, and you know, we thought that sounded cool, and we tried it. She died about 2 years ago from AIDS. Anyway, the first time I shot dope, I was hooked. The first time, and, you know, so don't think that can't happen. Don't think, oh, I'm just gonna try this once and you know, just the devil can't come in unless you invite him. You know, and then he never leaves. Never.
Hey, Matt.
Hey.
Yeah, this guy here is looking for someone on your beat. Maybe you want to talk to him real quick?
Oh, yeah, okay.
All right.
Thanks. What can we do for you?
I'm looking for my father. He'd be around 38 now. Last time I talked to him, he was living down here. But that was 5 years ago. He's a heroin addict.
An addict? Sorry, I don't recognize him. What's his name?
Ed Nivens. He used to teach high school.
This is your father? This is Ed.
Ed. Pigeon Park, Ed?
Yeah.
I am brought my little sister by to visit me.
Yeah? That go okay?
Really, really, really good.
Good. Good.
Can you get me into a rehab program again?
You know, it's going to be hard, huh? You know, you got to start all over again. Because you know you got to be straight on your own for 2 weeks before they let you in there again, eh?
I can do that. I can do 2 weeks.
Yeah, okay. Where are you going to stay? Where are you doing that?
I got a friend who can put me up.
Who? Not Joe.
He's straight again.
No, hey, listen. He'll never be straight. Okay? You go down there and stay with him on the skids, you're gonna be doing dope again.
No, I won't.
Yeah?
I won't.
Okay, we'll get you someplace else to stay. All right? Because, listen, you can't. You go down there, the temptation is just everywhere. You can't.
Joe knows what I'm going through, though.
Crystal?
Yeah. Okay. But not downtown.
No, not downtown.
I'm not going back down there. I want to make it this time, Artie. I really want to make it this time.
Hey. Any word on my missing person? Amber Riley?
No, nothing yet.
Let me know if anything comes in, whether I'm on shift or not, okay?
Okay, I'll make a note here.
Thanks.
Oh, Sergeant McTavish wants to see you and your partner.
I'm advising you that your rotation's up in a couple of days. I'll be putting a new team on your beat.
Sergeant, I think we made it pretty clear that we want to stay on down here.
Yeah, you have, but I think it's probably time we broke in a couple of new men.
Well, then I think we'll be making an appeal.
Well, that's fine. That's your prerogative.
Okay. On a different subject, I was wondering if you'd had a chance to see any of our video, because we've been circulating it for some reactions.
Yeah, I've seen some of it.
And what do you think?
Well, in my opinion, it makes us look like we condone drug addiction.
Well, we're trying to show what happens down here.
See, I don't think that's what the public expect of police. I think they want to see us doing our regular job, enforcing the law.
It's a deterrent.
Well, I think you're wasting your time. Anything else?
That pretty much covers it, I guess.
I'm sure this video is worth screwing up my career over, that's all I said.
Hey, if you guys are worried about being blacklisted, I mean, you gotta do what you gotta do. So I'm not throwing in the towel, that's all.
All right, I just gotta think about it, okay?
Yeah.
See you guys later.
Yeah. All right. Arnie.
Yeah?
It's not the same for these guys as it is for you. I mean, you got almost 20 years in, you're due to retire. What we're doing with this video?
Yeah.
We're making waves with the department, right?
Yeah, I know.
Well, we can handle a complaint if one comes down our way, but these guys are just starting out. They gotta watch their backs.
No, I understand. I understand. They gotta do what they gotta do. Inspector, you got a minute?
What can I do for you?
Well, you're going to hear about this, so you might as well know what all the noise is going to be about.
I already know what the noise is about. I've even seen the footage. A little raw, maybe, but effective.
Okay, that's great. I'm glad you feel that way. I'd like the opportunity to stay on rotation down here and at least get a chance to finish the project. And Sergeant McTavish is really pushing the rotation change.
Well, I think the sergeant probably has a different opinion about the effectiveness of what you're doing than some of the rest of us.
Yeah, you could say that.
I'll tell you what, if you can manage to finish the project without ruffling any more feathers, I'll see if I can finesse the situation.
I'd appreciate it.
What about your partner? You want to stay on the rotation with you?
I can't speak for my partner. But, appreciate it. Thanks.
Yeah, your guy Vic Pinto. He got into it with them in the club. He stabbed the kid in the arm.
Okay, thanks.
Yeah, he tried to run, but I got him. He's in the cruiser.
Thanks.
Hey, guys.
Well, you're in some trouble now, Vic. Assault, extortion. Yeah, Amber's parents are pressing charges.
I wouldn't know anything about that.
What about Amber? You know about her?
I don't know. I don't care.
Hey, don't pull a shit on me, Vic. I'm not in the mood.
She split a couple of weeks ago. Haven't seen her since.
We heard you sold her to another pimp.
I'm not saying another word until I talk to my lawyer.
Mm-hmm.
feeling? We've been looking for you.
How come you never told us you got a son?
What? You have about a 20-year-old son? He came to us looking for you.
Here. He's here?
Yeah, he came all the way across the country looking for you.
So what the hell did you let her out 3 hours early for?
She asked me to call her cab while her papers were signed. I guess she just wanted to get away.
You have no idea where she went?
No idea. I'm sorry.
Yeah, all right.
I'm gonna take the rotation change. I could use a break.
She's not a hooker, she sells cigarettes.
She sells cigarettes? I don't think I know her. What's her name?
No, you know her. Rose. Rose, like 5'3", 5'4", dark hair, high cheekbones. We went to pick her up at rehab, right. She was gone.
You got a minute?
Yeah.
You and your partner went over my head with a tape to the inspector. I don't appreciate that.
It wasn't my partner, it was me. And the inspector already made his own effort to see the tape. For the record, there's a lot of support for it in the department.
Yeah, and for the record, I also don't appreciate you giving the impression that just because I don't like your videotape, somehow I don't care for the addicts down here.
That's the impression you give.
No. No, my point is, I've told you this before, the citizens don't expect us to be movie makers. They expect enforcement.
Look out the window. It's not working.
But it's not your job to question police department policy.
I disagree.
Oh. All right. In the future, you got a problem with me, you come to me. Don't go over my head. That's it.
What we do is we head up to Kitts Beach, the pool, get the high school kids drinking there. We cut along Alma, up along Dunbar.
How long have you been looking for this girl, Amber?
Long time.
Double latte for you, cappuccino for me.
Okay. How you been?
I've been well. How's your mother?
She's sad. Just the same, you know? She never changes. You want to go get some food or something like that?
Yeah, I think it'd be a good idea.
Okay.
Listen, there's a burger joint right up the street there. Would that be okay with you?
It's fine. Yeah.
I think you'll like it. You look good. Dude, you look good.
He's gonna stay downtown.
Are you sure you want to change your beat?
Yeah, I've been working this skid so long, I feel like I need to come up for air, you know? Take a look around.
Is this about Arnie?
Maybe that's part of it.
Well, it makes me happy to have you out of there.
Tony. Oh, no. Oh. Has anybody told Arnie?
Threw her out with the garbage. Hey, hey, piss off. How you doing, Joe?
Good.
Yeah? Just wondering if you'd heard about Crystal.
Yeah.
She was talking about coming to see you, said you're clean, is that right?
Yeah, yeah.
Can you tell me the truth?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah? So I pat you down, I'm not gonna find anything, is that right?
I'm holding, but it's not mine. For someone else.
Which pocket?
It's in the pant pocket. Bad news about Crystal, huh? Do you know how she died?
And I went back to the hotel again. I found her baby back there on the bed. And some clothes, so she's around. I called her parents, told them she's back from Calgary.
What'd they say?
Well, they're exhausted. They're scared. No, they're not really even sure they want her back in the house anymore, you know. It's pretty traumatic getting beat up. So how's the new partner?
He's all right.
Yeah?
It's different.
But you're doing okay?
Yeah. Yeah, doing okay. Bored as hell.
Well, you want to come back downtown, it's not going anywhere. Check this out.
Oh my God.
Yeah!
Look at this. Hey, I've been looking all over for you guys.
Jesus. Where did you come from?
The island. I was staying with a friend from high school in Oak Bay. It's very hoity-toity.
You look fantastic.
Well, she was throwing this away. You believe that?
Hey, look, what happened out of rehab? Because we were out there and you were gone already.
I'm sorry. I just needed to make a break from everything. Even you guys.
Yeah, you know, it's probably a good idea. It looks like it's working so far.
Yeah. Anyway, it's shitty about Crystal.
Yeah, you heard.
Yeah, I read about it in the paper. You know anything yet? Is it going to be a funeral or a service or?
Well, coroner will get in touch with the family. They may want to do something.
Someone should. You let me know, okay?
Yeah.
I'd like to talk on tape again. You guys still doing that?
Oh, I don't know. Tony, we're still doing that?
Yeah. Yeah, we're still doing it.
That's great.
Okay, this car was stolen from a restaurant parking lot on 4th Avenue and then involved in the hit and run. Well, you've got the description of the car and the driver, so just keep an eye out.
Sergeant, I have a question.
Yep.
I've been thinking about Crystal, and she's on the tape a lot. And I think it would go a long way with the people who live down in the skids there if we held a funeral for her.
Anybody got anything else? Good, that's it.
I'm going to book the funeral parlor on the corner of Oppenheimer Park there. Yeah, everybody knows where it is. That way Crystal's friends will have no trouble finding it.
We're going to have a little reception afterwards with food and stuff.
Yeah. How many people are you expecting?
Oh, I don't know. We'll see. I mean, Crystal's got a lot of friends, hey? We'll just see who shows.
They'll show if they know about it. Hey, have you seen this memo that's floating around?
Yeah.
It's calling for a boycott of Crystal's funeral service.
Whoever it is, he's too chicken shit to put his name to it.
Don't sweat the memo. There's a lot of guys with you on that. A lot of guys think you're doing some good work, too.
Thanks.
When's the funeral?
Tomorrow.
You guys know her a long time?
Yeah, long time.
Hey, Artie, let's go. Parade's starting.
Yeah. Should never hurry to bury a friend. East Side. And people ask me what I did wrong to get assigned down here. I say I was born down here. This is my home. This is the life. I'm not going anywhere.